Hello everyone and welcome to Mods Logs. If you're an existing subscriber, thanks for your support and welcome back. Hope you're doing well. Probably going to be a pretty quick vlog today, hopefully, all going to plan. I'm going to be finally doing the debadging on the flower can. So, going to be getting rid of this stupid fake FPV badge and most likely going to be getting rid of the XR6 and the turbo badges as well. And if you do take this off, there's two holes there, so if you want to go full debadge, you got to shave it and bog it. So I just got this nice genuine Ford badge. It's going to go there. Leave those off. Should look a bit tidier and just not fake. So as well as those, I'm going to be getting rid of the stupid ones on the front fenders as well. These fully sick chrome fake FPV badges. Because as you can probably tell, it's not an F6, it's just an XR6 turbo. So putting FPV badges on it is pretty much like putting GDR badges on a GDS. So got the heat gun. They should be pretty straightforward. Just heat them up, peel them off, clean off the glue, in theory. And I'm also going to be plasti-dipping this section of my front bar black because I've seen a few photos and it looks sweet. So I've got some plasti-dip to give it a go. If I don't like it, peel it off, in theory, if it peels off. So yeah, if that sounds like something that's going to be interesting to you, stick around. So strangely enough, Sam doesn't actually own a hairdryer herself, which I just find really weird because I thought all girls just had one in their handbag at all times. But that's given me an excuse to go and buy myself an Azito little cordless 18 volt heat gun from Bunnings. It was like 70 bucks, I think, and I've got Azito batteries already from my Impact. So yeah, hopefully it does the job. We'll see how it goes. Just in case you're not aware why a heat gun, there's no judgment here on Mods Logs. Everyone's got to learn somewhere. It's just to soften the glue, like the adhesive that holds the badges on. So the theory is to heat it up with the heat gun. And then I've got some fishing line here that I can hopefully get in behind there and sort of just cut it and then clean whatever's left over with some eucalyptus oil or something similar. So yeah, and I'm back, my lovelies. I've got what looks like spray and wipe, but is actually this Shift It multi-purpose cleaner, which is good shit if you ask me. So I'm just gonna try and get the bulk off it if I can with this. It only makes it worse. Tequila, we're free, yeah. But in the morning, I wouldn't wanna be a heartache, heartbreak. Like girls hold down more than my stomach should take. Borracho from the tequila. Borracho, guns on the wine. Borracho, 40 out the 40. Borracho, most of the time. Another cup, I run a mug. I see a chick and I only wanna drink after drink. I slowly shake. She runs away from me, says, your brass tank. Borracho, I'm feeling funny. Borracho, must be the wine. Borracho, that girl was ugly. Borracho, but now she's fine. Borracho, hey. Borracho, ho. Borracho, most of the time. Sort of the sticky shit was a bit annoying. I had to get an edge of a credit card to get some of it off and then use some cut and polish just to get rid of the sticky residue off. But you can see guard one, no FPV. Come around the back. Tailgate. Just got a nice board badge and no XR6 or turbo there anymore. Come around to the other guard, check it out. And guard number two, no FPV. So now the only bit of crap that says FPV is the steering wheel, which I'm pretty sure you can just cut that off and get another one to stick over there. So one day I'll do that just to get completely rid of it. But yeah, good stuff. So now I'm just gonna mask this off a bit, sort of do a line there and just sort of follow that on both sides and just cover up some of this with some overspray, and we'll paint this middle bit black. See how it turns out, eh? And Dylan said to use painter's tape because apparently Plasti-Dip will soak through masking tape. So helpful tint from Dildo. You know who I'm talking about, is this bloke.
You wouldn't believe it, mate.
Funny. So you can see I've got my professional spray booth set up. So I've just used the painter's tape to mask off the shape, try to follow the shape of the bar, and just masked off the surrounding areas with some foil and a towel just for overspray, and blocked off the cooler with a cardboard box. This is how they do it at like West Coast Customs and stuff. So now all I've got to do is shake up the dip. This is what I got, just matte black Plasti-Dip. I was going to try gloss, but they didn't have it, so we'll do matte. So shake this up, give it a coat, peel it off, and either hate myself or go, oh, that looks all right. See what happens. Worked out pretty sweet. I think I'm just gonna try redo that little bit where it started to peel off, where the dip started to dry. I might see if I can just straighten that up. But other than that, it's pretty good. That's that, all Dunskies. Stoked with how that turned out. I reckon that looks pretty sick. I'm quite wrapped with that result. I'm even Plasti-Dipped with how that turned out. Badges are Gonskies. Car needs a clean, but ignore that. I'll get that done maybe when that Plasti-Dip's fully dry. Tailgate, it's a Ford again, nice and tidy. And yeah, got someone coming to pick up the old badge and grill for a pineapple. That's a pretty easy $50. And yeah, like always, if you liked the video, make sure you actually click the like button. If you disliked it, just keep it to yourself. It hurts. Yeah, like, subscribe, click the bell. Do all that. I'll try to put something else out ASAP. Thanks for watching, guys. Bye-bye.